Hi everyone, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. In this lesson, we are going to look at how you can build a very, very famous, iconic Mixolydian chord progression derived from what we call as the Mixolydian mode or the Mixolydian scale. So what we are going to do in this lesson is we are first going to form the scale. Then we are going to look at how we build a very Mixolydian sounding chord progression. We'll look at a few examples. We'll try and get as creative as possible. And that's pretty much the lesson. So let's get cracking right away. And if you haven't already, do head over to part one, where we look at plagal cadences, where we try to build the structure of what we are trying to do in today's class. Okay. And also revise the circle of fifths, which was also talked about earlier. And we've also done a lot of circle of fifths videos. If you are not so sure of the circle, there are a lot of videos to teach you the circle. Let's get started right away. So the first thing I want to do is build the Mixolydian scale. Let's do it on the key of C. C Mixolydian is this. You see, it's very similar to the major scale. The only difference being it has the 7 flat, which in this case is B flat. B flat is called as the minor 7th or the dominant 7th, right? And this is a great chord which demonstrates that mode. C dominant 7th or C7th. Okay? So that's about the Mixolydian. Why don't we just, for clarity's sake, build it on a couple of other scales? Maybe G Mixolydian. All your white notes. F sharp comes down to F, flattens. Okay, F. F Mixo. Okay, B flat Mixo. Okay, A. Right, and it's a nice habit to kind of formulate your scales on all the keys and all the roots, because on the keyboard, on the piano, what tends to happen is every scale has a certain feeling for your fingers. Your fingers attach to the notes in a very, very different manner, you know, as you play from key to key or scale to scale. So the music you end up constructing on C Mixolydian might be very, very radically different than what you compose maybe on an A flat Mixolydian or a B flat Mixolydian. And I have observed this with a lot of my music, which I've worked on over the years. You know, whenever you just change the scale or change the mode, you just get different ideas. So that's a quick point I wanted to bring across. So coming back to the domain of C, C Mixolydian. Okay. Now when we harmonize this scale to build chord progressions, we will find that there are 3 major chords, 3 minor chords and 1 diminished chord. The reason being that the Mixolydian mode or scale, if you will, comes from a major scale. It's just a major scale starting from another degree. For example, the C Mixo has pretty much the same chords as F major. Right? So if you start F from C, you get the C Mixo. Mixolydian scale, right? But right now I'm not looking at it as deriving it as such. I'm just saying that you can get the chords of any Mixolydian scale by figuring out which major scale it is derived from. So in this case, the C Mixolydian is derived from the F scale. How do we do that? F major, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. F, G, A, B flat, C. Okay? Or go up a fourth. C, D, E, F, and you get the major scale. So that's one way of doing it. And then you realize, oh yeah, the major chords happen to be C major, F major, B flat major, F major, and C major, because those are all the major chords of F major, right? Another way of doing it is the usual triad approach, where you write down the entire scale in a neat round circle, and then you get triads. C major, D minor, 3 diminished, E diminished, 4 major, which is F major, 5 minor, 6 minor, 7 major, rather 7 flat major. If you look at it with respect to the major, B flat is the 7 flat, right? So 7 flat, and then you end with the 1, which is just a repeat. So 1 major, 2 minor, 3 diminished, 4 major, 5 minor, 6 minor, 7 major, and back to 1 major. Okay, so we are not going to use all of those chords in this exercise. We are just going to take the major chords, and a great Mixolydian chord progression which you could start off with or pretty much use for a lot of years because it's very cool would be you start with the 7 flat major. Now, what is the 7 flat with respect to C? That, right? B flat. So that's 7 flat, and then you do 1, 2, 3, 4, the 4 major. Remember, in the Mixolydian world, the 1, the 4, and the 7 flat are major. It's not 1, 4, and 5. That would have been in the major scale. So in the Mixo, it's 1, the 4, F major, the 7 flat, B flat major. So the progression is 7 flat, 4 major, 1 major. Okay, so you go, let's keep that going. And what we do is we could play that one chord a bit longer. That's kind of a nice way to ensure the tonality or to give the listener the sense that, hey, you are in C something. You're in C Mixolydian. So we play that last chord a little longer. Very common in a chord progression to do that. Even in a 2-5-1 jazz cadence, you make the one a bit longer, right? So 7 flat, F major, which is 4 major, 1 major played a little longer. So this is 2 counts for this chord, 2 counts for that, 4 counts for that. Or you could spread it out. 4, da-da-de. 4 of the F, and 2 bars of the C major. Or make it a bit quicker. 2 beats. I'm forced to also sing. I get by with little help from my friends. Ooh, I'm gonna try with little help from my friend. That's the same chord progression for the Beatles' hit With a Little Help from My Friends. 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 1. So it's a very kind of brave, epic brotherhood kind of scale where you're like part of this community and you're trying to take over the world or something, you know. It's just a very epic sounding scale. So it's used not necessarily, not generally at least, for like a one-to-one communication, like a love song. It's more, you know, like something to do with a group, you know, like With a Little Help from My Friends, which is a kind of a group kind of perspective. Okay, so you go 7 flat, 4 major, and then 1 major. So let's build this on a few more scales to get more clear with everything. So if I'm on the F scale, E flat will be the Mixolydian, right? So how do I do the 7 flat 4-1? E flat major, B flat, and then F. Sing your favorite songs. I get by with a little help from my friends. Yeah. Let's try it on the key of G. That'll also be nice. G Mixo. So your entire progression is going to have white notes now. 7 flat of G will be F major. F major. C major. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da. G. I get by with a little help from my friend. Ooh, get by with a little help from my friend. nice way to practice it, just to play the chords. However, as a piano player, there's something really cool you could try. I'm going to go back to the C mixo and develop the chords only in my bass hand or in my left hand and play it. Just keep that, you know. And look at some improv. Four. So I'm holding the C chord for a bit longer. So maybe you could start your improvisation by jamming on something in the right hand while your left hand just chills out by landing on that C chord. So something like that. Your right hand's free. You could even jam when you're playing on the Mixolydian. Another nice scale to work into could be is the major blues scale. Which is major pentatonic with that 3 flat, making it very bluesy. So that's your Mixolydian progression or cadence, if you will. 7 flat, 4, 1. You need to practice this on all keys. And a great way to help you do this or achieve this would be write down the circle of fifths. And then you're going to look at 3 chord groupings in that circle. So the circle, when you write it, C, G, D, A, E, B, F sharp, D flat, A flat, E flat, B flat, F, C. You write it like that. And as you move clockwise, you move clockwise with 3 elements or 3 points or 3 chords, right? So if I take C, which is at 12 o'clock in the circle, you can do B flat going to F going to C, and that's your Mixolydian progression right there. So just staring at the circle of fifths more often than not can really help you compose very, very unique chord progressions, which very few people use these days, you know. Since the Beatles and maybe since the 90s, really, chord progressions have ended up being very diatonic or in some instances, very much 1-5-6-4-like, which is pretty much all the pop songs out there. So this might spice things up and add a new flavor to your audience who you're performing your music for. So how do we build the progression? Either 7-flat-4-1 of the Mixolydian scale, write that down, or we can just build it from the circle of fifths. So if I take B flat, climb one more clockwise, F, one more clockwise, C, and you have the entire Mixolydian progression right there. Right, guys, again, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. Hope you found the lesson useful. If you did, do give the video a like, share it, comment for something else we could do in the future, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already and hit the bell icon for regular notifications and lessons which are going to keep hitting you very, very shortly. Cheers.